This is the latest installment in The Docket, an ongoing series from the NPR Politics podcast where we look at the biggest legal questions of the day. Subscribe to the NPR Politics podcast here. As yet another wave of COVID-19 spreads throughout the United States, we've seen businesses, cities, and parts of the federal government begin to require proof of vaccination. Those mandates have sparked a debate over not just the ethics of vaccination, but also the legality. Is it legal to require vaccination to perform your job? Or go to a sporting event or restaurant? NPR Justice correspondent Kerry Johnson and political correspondent Danielle Kurtzleben put those questions to law professor Lindsay Wiley from American University in Washington, D.C., where she directs the Health Law and Policy Program. The following conversation has been edited for length and clarity. There is Jacobson versus Massachusetts, a Supreme Court case from 1905. The case itself was about a vaccination mandate. In the early 1900s, smallpox outbreaks were fairly frequent and many people had been vaccinated earlier as children, but needed to be vaccinated as their immunity waned. The state of Massachusetts passed a law that gave authority to local boards of health to make a decision at any given moment in response to an outbreak that smallpox vaccination should be mandatory for all residents of their local area if, in the opinion of the medical experts who were serving on the board, it was necessary to protect the public's health. The city of Cambridge made that determination. They then went through the effort of outreach to get everyone vaccinated. When they came to Henning Jacobson, he objected. He argued that vaccines are ineffective. He argued that they don't prevent transmission. And he argued that they were harmful. The court described those arguments as not seeking a medical exemption, but rather reciting the alternative views that differ from medical consensus and that those arguments did not warrant an exemption from the requirement to be vaccinated. I think it's a combination of the two. Actually, there are different constraints, not based on individual rights, but based on federalism and also separation of powers. What I do think we're likely to see is some incentives and conditions on things like participation in Medicare for hospitals and maybe skilled nursing facilities, nursing homes. But that's very different from the kinds of mandates that we're seeing employers adopt and that we're seeing at least a couple of local jurisdictions consider for patrons of certain businesses. It's very common for healthcare employers to require flu shots and a whole host of other shots as a measure to protect patients, but also to some extent to protect health workers themselves. So, for example, many require hepatitis vaccinations in addition to flu shots and all of the kind of childhood vaccines that we tend to get as a condition of attending school.